Let's start today with the definition of the characteristic of a ring. It's kind of an odd seeming concept here. And it's relevant for the group structure of a ring. So it makes you wonder, why don't we talk about characteristic with groups? And well, we could, but we focus on it more with rings. The characteristic of a ring is the least positive integer n, such that nx equals x, zero for all x in the ring. Think about what this means. N is not a ring element here. N is a positive integer. X is a ring element. What is nx? It's x added to itself n times. The operation here, even though it looks like a multiplication, is really addition. And zero is the additive identity. So we're talking about the least positive integer, such that when you add any ring element to itself n times, you get the additive identity. You could talk about this in group theory. And if you were talking about it in group theory, you would be focused on an equation like this instead, g to the n equals e. Okay? So again, we could talk about it in group theory, but it's saved to ring in theory here. Does this mean it's the order of x? Is the order of x equal to n? The answer is no, though we'll see there is a relationship to order. We do know from Lagrange's theorem in group theory that if G is a finite group of order n, then for any element A in G, if you raise A to the n power, you do get the identity. We do know that, but that doesn't mean the characteristic of G is n. It could be less than n. For example, in the external direct product of z2 with itself, for example, the identity has order 1 and all the other elements have order 2, the other three elements. The characteristic of this would have been 2, not 4. The number of elements is 4. Okay. Coming back to this definition, if no such integer exists, we say R has characteristic zero, which makes you, it's kind of weird. Maybe you would think of the characteristic should be infinity or something. But no, we say the characteristic is zero. And the characteristic of R is denoted by this notation, char or char R, whatever you want to say. What's more interesting with characteristic is thinking about it with infinite rings. Infinite rings can have finite characteristic. I mentioned this last time. A ring like, say, Z2X, always remember for the rest of the semester what this is. It's a ring of polynomials with coefficients in Z2 where you add and multiply polynomials in the usual way, except at the end you mod the coefficients by 2, not the powers. This has characteristic 2, even though it's an infinite ring. It's an infinite ring because the polynomials can be arbitrarily high degree. Million degree, billion degree, Google degree, 10 to the millionth power degree, okay. Arbitrarily high degree polynomials, there's infinitely many polynomials, even though Z2 only has two elements, 0 and 1. All the coefficients of these polynomials are either 0 or 1. And they do have a maximal degree. We're not talking about infinite series here. It still has characteristic 2. You take any polynomial in there and add it to itself. So, quote unquote, multiply it by 2 means add it to itself. Combine like terms. And then at the end, you do need to mod the coefficients by 2. It's giving us the zero polynomial, the additive identity. Okay. Obviously, that's going to work no matter what polynomial in there that we have. So this has got characteristic 2. And again, we're only talking about the group structure here, just the addition. We could be talking about this purely in group theory if we wanted to. In general, the characteristic of Zn of x is n. Okay. Couple theorems. They're not super important theorems for us, but they're worth noting. Let R be a ring with unity one. There's something that's not in group theory, right? Unities. In group theory, if we're talking about the operation being addition, zero is the additive identity. If we've got a ring now and we're thinking about a unity, we're thinking about the multiplication. So if we've got a ring with unity one, the multiplicative identity, if one has infinite order under addition as a group element, then the characteristic of R is zero. If one has order n under addition, then the characteristic of R is n. You only have to look at the unity and what is its additive order. That's interesting, maybe a little surprising. Proof's not too hard. You should study it, okay? Something is an example of something you should be able to do on the next exam. I'll let you study the proof. Ring does have to have unity for this theorem to be relevant, okay? So we are focused on rings with unity. Another theorem is that the characteristic of an integral domain is either zero or prime. If you know you got an integral domain and you happen to be wondering what its characteristic is, it's either zero or it's prime, no other possibilities. This would apply to fields too, because fields are integral domains. By the way, you might wonder, is that a field? Is Z2X a field? I mean, after all, Z2 is, right? Z2 by itself. Two-element field with unity. Actually, fields have to have unity. Two-element field, is this a field? The answer is no. Rings of polynomials are never, ever, ever fields. Rings of polynomials are never, ever, ever fields, even when the coefficients come from a field. I hope that's somewhat intuitive, because to be a field, you'd have to have a multiplicative inverse. And if a polynomial like this, we're going to have a multiplicative inverse, it wouldn't have to be like 1 over x squared plus x. And that wouldn't be a polynomial. That would be a rational function, not a polynomial. Maybe rational functions form a field. Maybe. Yeah, we'll talk about that later.